We've all seen our fair share of American political ads in recent years, but the very first? That could be Common Sense, an 18th century pamphlet designed to incite rebellion. In the first months of 1775, tensions between the 13 British colonies in North America and the British Empire itself were at a breaking point. Higher taxes imposed by the British Parliament weighed heavily on many colonists, and by April 19th, the American Revolutionary War was on. Despite a damning response from King George III, many Americans were unconvinced that breaking away from Britain was the best way forward. So radical thinker and revolutionary Thomas Paine wrote Common Sense, a 47-page pamphlet that laid out the arguments for independence, published by Paine anonymously in 1776 and addressed to the American people. Common Sense threw serious shade at the British monarchy and called for Americans to take up arms in the fight for self-government. Because most literate Americans had learned to read through the Bible, Paine presented his arguments as mini sermons, using biblical language designed to fire up American hearts and minds and galvanize support for American independence. An estimated 120,000 copies of Common Sense went into circulation, and when Paine was finally revealed as the author, he gained celebrity status, particularly among members of the newly formed Continental Congress, many of whom finally felt comfortable to express their opposition to King George. So why does it matter? Common Sense proved that political works could be effective in shifting public opinion. Think about how messages in the media are designed to connect with us today. Are there any similarities?